Hi Gemini, welcome to your mid-February check-in. This is a general reading, so please take what resonates and leave the rest. If you'd like a more personalized experience, please check the description box below to book a one-on-one session with me. There's also information there regarding the decks that I used in this reading, as well as a link to my upcoming course, Total Tarot, which is starting February 23rd. It's a subscription-based course, drop in anytime. Great for those who like to do a little self-study, as well as get really deep into the cards. So check that out if you're interested. And as always, the link to donate is down below if you'd like to leave a little love offering. So, anyways, without further ado, let us dive in. I'm going to pull some chakra cards here because I love dealing with color. It's one of my favorites. So, let's see what we've got for you, Gemini. Interesting. Okay. Okay. So, starting off, we have psychic abilities. Dealing with the third eye, self-esteem, solar plexus, and communication, throat chakra. All right. So I kind of want to put these in a specific order because I like doing it in the flow, in the energy flow, right? So there's something about your self-esteem here that is affecting your communication and your clarity. Now, whether there's something that you're unsure about, whether it's some maybe trying to figure out what is really yours, what you're really interested in, what you really want to communicate out into the world, may have something to do with your craft or the type of work that you do. You may have felt blocked in certain instances, feel unsupported, and now it's just a matter of figuring out that space where you can show up, where you can communicate, where people can truly see you as you are. Because sometimes, Gemini, the thing is, people see you and they don't really know what to expect, right? And that can be a good thing, but it can also be very frustrating at times, right? And so I feel like tuning into your communication skills and your psychic abilities will help you understand how to get the message across to different people, or maybe even a broader audience if that's something that's up your boat, right? So, all right, so let's see what else we've got here. Oh, all right, so we have a lot of purple. So crown stuff, right? So we have mystery, creativity, and sweetness. I'm gonna leave this reversed for right now. So again, it's this lack of clarity, lack of focus. There's something that you want to create, maybe you're wanting to recreate yourself, but it's really necessary for you to figure out what the focus is. Where are you lacking that energy? Where do you hold or carry a certain amount of self-doubt, right? And it could be that there's a lot of anger. There's a lot of feeling some sort of resentment or and I feel like it's mainly toward you. I don't think it's geared toward anyone else. It doesn't feel like that. But for some reason, you've been beating yourself up for some reason. And instead of really owning things, you've allowed yourself to kind of shy away from the things that excite you in some form or fashion. And I really feel like you have been somewhat unkind to yourself behind closed doors. And in an interior aspect, you've been shutting yourself off from different possibilities, options, things that you would really enjoy doing. And but spirit's just like, no, look, like you're really good at this. You just have to have the heart to do it, right? You ha just have to be able to have the courage and the confidence to move forward. Let's pull some tarot here. So we have the Nine of Cups reversed. We have the Hermit. We have the High Priestess. So it's like, yeah, spending all of this time kind of by yourself or in your own mind, feeling like there's really no one in your corner, feeling really alone, feeling really isolated, which is pretty easy these days. But a lot of things are kind of coming up from the subconscious. There's a lot of having to get to the source of why you feel undeserving of certain things. You have a lot of great support around you, but I don't think that you're always willing to ask for help. There are a lot of people with great ideas. You have great ideas, but for some reason, you've built this really like kind of fancy wall around yourself just naturally. And I think it has to do with maybe some aspect of your personality that makes you feel like you're present and then you're engaged, but it's really not. It almost feels like some facade of some sort, where you're not really giving yourself the chance or giving other people the chance to fully recognize you and to see you. And instead, it's like you're kind of giving them scraps or, bits and pieces of who you are and keeping the rest of you kind of covered up, keeping your desires unknown for fear that people may speak out against them, for fear that no one's going to quite understand you or get you. But it's like you're kind of turning your back on the path, on all of this knowledge and illumination that's coming forth for you. But it's like you've got to open up and be way more receptive. Allow yourself to really pay attention to the signs that are showing up for you. Pay attention to the people that are in your life right now, and keep showing up and showing up for you, and to get to know you despite whatever walls or boundaries you keep putting up. Because it's really you getting in your own way. It's you kind of going, teeter-tottering between these two extremes when it's really a good time to find balance, a good time to go just straight forward and not kind of dilly-dally and zigzag between can't I, what's wrong with me, right? It's like you feel like you haven't really been making much progress, but it's because you've been playing these games with yourself and playing these games with others. And so here with this Nine of Cups reversed, we have the Eight of Wands and the Four of Wands. Lots of movement, lots of creative energy. It could be people that you're rooming with or something like that, but there's a lot of great ideas. There's a lot of great energy. There's a lot of change that could happen very quickly if you just open yourself up and show up and engage in an authentic way and really be part of the excitement there. You're in the right energy. You just gotta get clear on how you want to show up and participate, right? And then we have this Ten of Pentacles with the Hermit card and creativity and communication. Like, it's all there. You're a creative communicator. You've got a lot to say. You've got a lot to share. And perhaps you could learn a few things as well. This is something that you can be fully committed to and allow you to feel a sense of stability, a sense of community, and not holding yourself up in some tower or some concept or idea of who you are and what's not for you, right? Instead, let's start choosing what is for you. Let's come to the other side of that and really allow yourself to create a family here. There's like, I feel like this community, it feels like family. It feels really good. And I feel like sometimes you feel like you may be working too much on trying to balance your energy in order to meet others, or it may be a lot of exciting, maybe too overstimulating at times, which creates this kind of hermit mode, this closing off. But I also feel like this is something that you've kind of learned over time. It's something that you've adopted. It's some type of involuntary kind of mechanism that you kind of lean into when things feel overwhelming and you feel incapable of really navigating things. You want things to be more, I don't want to say predictable, but you're seeking that sense of control, right? And then with this Nine of Swords and the High Priestess, this Nine of Swords reverse, it's like the more you open up to receiving these things, recognizing all of the opportunity that's around you, all of the support that you have, opening your heart up a little bit more, showing yourself a little bit more compassion, and not being so cold, but being even keeled, leveled, relaxed. You're gonna be able to, I feel like, go much farther than you thought you could before. I'm really paying attention to this blanket for some reason, so I don't know if someone has like a security blanket or something that they utilize. But there's something in that I'm really paying attention to, and it's like you may kind of ridicule yourself for the certain habits or the certain comforts that you do have, certain coping mechanisms that you have, and it's like recognize, okay, I don't have to judge myself for this, right? Maybe if, unless you have some type of coping mechanisms that deal in terms of substances, dealing with substance abuse in any type of way, it's time to seek that type of help. there are people around you in that regard, if that's what we're talking about here, there are other people that have also had those same types of trials and tribulations. People that can help you and support you and give you resources that you need in order to break through from that and begin that road to recovery. And that could also be what is keeping you isolated. There may be a lot of secrets that you have. You're afraid, you judge yourself, and instead of really allowing your story to be a place of empowerment for yourself and others, you're just holding on to it and allowing it to punish you. You're punishing yourself. It's kind of becoming some type of toxic space for you where you may be resenting your life and your life choices, and that is not fair. So I would like to pull out maybe one more card for you here. All right, and we have determination. So with this, I also think of the Sun card, and I'd like to pull out one more tarot card. We have the Ten of Cups. So you're gonna find that way through. And this will be a breakthrough to you, for you, that carries you into a new phase, that allows you to start making the changes you want to make in your physical world, in your health, in terms of your energy, in terms of what you create as well, and what that flow looks like. Because it may have been a bit of stop and go. It may have been a little like, okay, things are going and now they're not, especially these days, right? But it's like, it's much like climbing a mountain, you know, sometimes you're not going straight up, right? Either due to altitude, due to the terrain, the weather conditions, it feels like a meandering thing. Sometimes you have to backtrack. Sometimes you got to do this. And then you reach the peak and like, then you're able to see why and how you're being guided through it and to find gratitude for it, because it could have been much more challenging had you just decided to go zoop, zoop. So yeah, just be more receptive and listen to the lay of the land. Listen, you know, pay attention, really listen to and receive what's there, because it's guiding you, it's showing you everything that you need is all around you. So take some time to get outside of yourself. Take a break from that negative self-talk. Get some new hobbies, interests, ways of kind of coping and processing your internal narrative. So that is what I have for you, Gemini. I hope that was helpful. Again, check the description box below for lots of lovely links and goodies and information. And until March, bye.